Well, welcome to evening prayer. It's Tuesday, the 24th of October. Yay! We just had a birthday in the last week here, and my wife's birthday. These are from Nathan and Mahela. Nice balloons. I've got balloons rather than flowers tonight because we're thinking about rejoicing, about God and our rejoicing, and there's a bit of celebration going on there. Before we come to that idea and that psalm, let's pray. Father, thank you for being our Father. Thank you that although in human life, parenting is a difficult thing and sometimes our experience of parents cannot always be good, we thank you that as the song says, you are a good, good Father. You are that waiting Father, looking down the road for his son coming home. And in a way, you wait for us again through our days when we're too busy for you. And then we find this moment to come down the road to sit at your feet again. You're still welcoming. You still put your arm around us. Come and spend time with me. So we thank you for this evening hour, if that's what it is for us, unless we watch at other times. But whatever it is, set aside for you, we just sit and we remember and we wait and we receive your love. We invite you, Holy Spirit, to come and make this a place of sanctuary and safety. A place where you might bless us away from the run of things, the busyness of life. Surround us with your care, Lord Jesus, tonight. We ask it in your name. Amen. So our friend Jason Silver, who sings the Psalms, doesn't he? And has been doing for our evening prayers and online worship, is going to sing to us now Psalm 149. And then we'll think about that.
Praise the Lord. Sing to the Lord a new song. Sing his praise. Execute vengeance on all the nations, and punishment on peoples there. fetters, they're nobles with chains of iron to execute his judgment. This is glory for all his faithful ones. Praise the Lord, sing to the Lord a new song, sing his praise.
So the greatness of God tonight is simply he's the God of our rejoicing, or if you like, he's the God of our worship. It's really, really important that it's not just something we should do. You know, I must go to church to worship God. It's something that God delights in. It's something he celebrates with us. It's something that he engages with us in. It's not a one-way show where we're singing hymns to him or even to each other. Sometimes it feels like, doesn't it? But that we are engaging in that encounter where God enjoys our worship and gives us things in our worship, and we celebrate. And so Psalm 149 that Jason's saying, it says all about praising him in the assembly of his faithful people. So we're in church, there's a dancing and there's musicians. We'll come to music another night. And he takes delight, it says, in his people. Isn't that lovely? He takes delight in us. And then it says, it finishes up by saying this, let his faithful people rejoice in his honor, in dishonor, and sing for joy on their beds. So worship is not just about being in the sanctuary. It's not just about the assembly and about being together. We can worship when we're on our own, perhaps the last thing at night, or when we're just going to bed. We can worship him there. So in the big and the small, we can worship. He is the God of our rejoicing. All places can be places of praise if we let them be. Let's pray. We thank you, Lord, for worship. We thank you for our church. We thank you for those times that have inspired us when we have been lost in wonder, love and praise. We thank you for our times of a quiet time, our walks with you, our reflecting upon you, our reading your word. We thank you we can rejoice almost as we awake. I know sometimes we wake very bleary-eyed, but God is around us. We can praise him. We can praise him when we go to bed. There is no place, Lord, that you cannot be praised, enjoyed, rejoiced about, worshipped. So we thank you for all those. And we pray for those who we know who might be able to know that they can have real spaces where they can encounter you. Help us to be those who witness to the fact that you are everywhere and can be enjoyed in every place. And we sum up our prayers by praying the prayer of the kingdom as we say together, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. So our final song, Amy Grant, with her usual build-up in this one, is going to remind us that we need to sing our praise to the Lord. Come on, everybody. So let's listen to Amy, and I'll see you again tomorrow for more How Great Thou Art.
mama. Hallelujah, give your praise to the Lord. I can never tell you just how much good that is gonna do you just to sing anew the song your heart learned to sing when he first gave his life to you. The life goes on and so must the song you gotta sing again. The song born in your soul when you first gave your heart. Lord, come on everybody, stand up and sing one more hallelujah, give your praise to the Lord. I can never tell you just how much good that it's gonna do you just to sing aloud the song that someone is dying to hear down in the maddening crowd. As you once were before you heard the song, you gotta let them know the truth is alive to shine upon the way so maybe they can go. Your praise to the Lord. Come on everybody, stand up and sing one more hallelujah, give your praise to the Lord. I can never tell you just how much good that it's gonna do you just to let the name of the Lord be praised both for now and evermore. Praise him all you servants, give your praise to the Lord. Come on everybody, stand up and sing one more hallelujah.